I can't go back to any land I've conquered. I'm disappointed. That is so stupid! There were like all these alternate paths.
Was built for gathering squirt extract and copious supply.
I think that's a bad design decision.
Nothing more healthful.
Alright, so what do I do here? Oh, defeat him quick?
Some folks showed up to make a fast buck with nothing but a knife.
Gotta kill the spawners, that's first. Priority is the spawner.
Other folks came to train their throwing arms.
It's so hard to actually pick what you want.
Slippery little devils. Still others use the place to test their finest blades.
This is precisely why I don't like the dagger. The aiming is weird. I mean, I could cycle through opponents, yes, but not how I'd like to. Oh, do the turrets not count as enemies? If that's the case, I wasted my time killing them.
Kid cuts all of them down soon enough.
Oh, wow. That wasn't very good at all.
Always time for juice and squirts, they used to say.
Well, I think the time limit is like 1 minute. What if we... Oh, no. Get the spawners. Spawners first. Spawners first. Does it even matter the damage you take? Alright, then you get the turrets. Oh, that only knocks it down. I see. Oh, but you can't hit it when it's turtled? Oh, is that the gimmick?
Can't feel a thing.
You can't hit it when it's turtled. You have to kill it by throwing. This challenge is so stupid.
Some squirts tried to flee on instinct.
You know what? I'm not going to do it on that run.
The ranch
was try
always
again.
Looking for good help.
Okay, immediately go for the spawner. Okay, you can worry about the turrets later. Kill the ones in mass. It's better to kill them while they're still on a surface. Rather than throwing. Throwing individually takes forever. Yeah, this challenge is stupid, and I don't like this weapon. It's so random! At least the other challenges were static, you know? It was like, okay, you gotta do this. This is kinda like praying they all group up right. This is, I don't know. This challenge is dumb. I foresee, like, there's a lot of failure at states. Look at this motherfucker. God, I hate the targeting here. I may actually do this challenge with keyboard and mouse if I'm able to aim where I want to. I think that's the biggest problem. I'm trusting the auto aim. The auto aim is shit. Yeah, it works in a simplistic sense, but I can't, like, look at that. I gotta trust in it. I'm gonna see if I can switch to mouse and keyboard for this challenge. I think I did worse. Holy fuck. is the problem with auto-aim? You know what? Okay. I'm gonna see if I can actually, like switch my controls there for that. That was stupid. Let's see. Let's see what we can do here. Let's switch to, mouse and keyboard. Under 90 seconds. Okay. I got mouse and keyboard now. This is how you do this. How much better is this? Where's my dodge? Alright, that's my dodge. Alright, that's all I need to know, my dodge and my movement. Movement's harder, but the ability to shoot is so refined. Alright, now let's see what we have. How good we do here.
There's always more squirts to go around.
Alright, I'm probably not gonna do it the first time, because I'm still getting used to it. Alright. You should really try to kill as many as you can while they're still here. Oh, with being able to actually aim at what I want to changes. Okay, now kill the squirts. I'm not much better than auto-aim! There is so much RNGesus in this challenge. Yeah, I'm more so with the dagger, but I do enjoy actually aiming it. That's different. You really gotta leave these sons of bitches. Look at you dodging. What's left? What fail? Do I have a special that I could use here? I don't know. I think I might just not do this challenge. It's kind of a lame challenge. It requires a whole lot of things going right. I don't know. Let me see. Let me try back with the keyboard. I mean with the controller here. That didn't go much better. Although it was neat to be able to shoot with my, let's see here, maybe my strategy's off. Maybe I should really just try to clear as many early and not go for the. No, I think these things keep spawning, so going after these is essential. But I should kill them while they're still, look at this, there's a fucking party in the middle! not what you want to aim for. I'll settle for second place. I think it's quicker to try to run up to them and get them before they dance off. Where's the last one? What? That was under 90 seconds. No, I think I have to kill everything. I'm gonna settle for the second place. I don't really care to get first place. This challenge is like, I don't know. It's not fun. That's my biggest thing against it. It's not fun. So it's not worth doing for that reason alone. Certain squirts don't count. Oh, certain squirts don't count? No, I think every enemy counts. To my reckoning. Better to get them when they're on the edge. Stabbing is a million times better than throwing. Where's the last one?
Kid makes short work of them things.
Yeah, I don't. What is the next one? I'm curious, what are they actually it probably is a minute. I'm so curious. I'm not gonna do it. I'm just curious. What is the stipulation for perfection? Oh, I think I gotta complete it anyway. No, I'd rather fail. I'd gladly fail. It is 60 seconds? Fuck that. That would take so many attempts. You know, having played it for an hour, I will say that I don't like the gameplay to this. It's not engaging at all. Well, one, because it's not hard. And two, it's, I don't know. It's already kind of repetitive, and I haven't even played that long. I guess, the mark against it is a lack of challenge, and then the, challenges like this really, like, show the flaws in the fighting. I gotta win. No, just die. Just die. I'm sure you can fail if you die. Just die.
Squirts can be dangerous, like any livestock.
No! I'm trapped here. I have to win. Okay. Transistor looks a lot like this game, though. It's early to tell, you know? It's really early to tell if this game's that great or anything, but Honestly, my first impressions are, I don't know how this was an indie darling. It seems, by all accounts, kind of like a lame video game. I don't hold nothing back, man. Ron Perlman's voice is so sexy, but it suffers.
Kid comes back from Windbag Ranch, smelling good and ripe.
But it suffers from. Oh wait, I could have done it the whole time. Woo! Dance with me, my friend. It's weird though. I know. I think public perception. Oh, you built a tent for yourself. Okay. I mean, you've been doing here nothing.
Here and there.
I thought public perception for this game was that it was magnificent. Like, overwhelming positive thoughts. I mean, it's not per se a bad game, but it feels bland. Yeah, Ron Perlman's talking up a storm, but ultimately he's not really saying all that much. I mean, at a certain point he's like saying, okay, this level's over, leave. Check this side, don't forget to check this angle. Some of the design points are questionable. I can't revisit levels? Why? That's stupid. Furthermore, like, that challenge was lame. It was just pure lame. In fact, the fang shooting challenge was kind of lame as well. All it really has going for it is it's cute. You know, it's cute. Let's do the Hanging Gardens.
The Hanging Gardens. Folks used to go here to relax from their relaxing.
Nah, I'm glad I played it. You know, I'm glad I'm playing all these games and actually trying. I'm seeing it. This is my. I'm forming my opinions from what I'm actually experiencing versus going off, you know, what people are saying. That's very important, you know? You gotta taste the food before you can tell the chef that he burnt it. But, I don't know. This game. I don't know. It's not tickling me the right way. It's the gameplay is so like it's just monotonous. It's not engaging. There's not really a lot of receptive feedback. It's easy as fuck. There's an overabundance of potions, and so far the story is not that like engaging. Oh well. At least I like Ron Perlman. Although you could tell
the dead welcome him with open arms.
Alright, let's see if this level's any better. Not only that, I don't know how I feel about my protagonist yet. I mean, if he were narrating, I'd care more. But he's not narrating. He's just.
The calamity took everybody after all.
It did.
Kid sees it plain, frozen faces all around.
Ah, oh. That's sad, but I must murder you!
You don't care to see him. Not like this.
Not like this. Not like this. It can't end like this. I wonder what like the Metacritic score for this type of game is, you know? I'm curious now. It's just weird to go from playing God Hand, which was a game all about the gameplay with somewhat stylish presentations, but the presentation was kind of bare bones, but that game was carried so well because it was fun. This game is like the complete opposite of the spectrum. And you know, sometimes I appreciate oh, these two old people died together. And so I'll send them together. And yeah, this is on the opposite. You know, sometimes I can turn my brain off and just enjoy a plot-driven game that's, you know, just kind of see the adventure through. But I don't know. This one is not. It's just not very engaging with its story either.
These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close.
Furthermore, I just don't really feel games that are narrated to such a degree. That's weird, because I like the first two Max Paynes, but those had really a lot of style. But I don't know, I just never been a fan of games that kill these people.
Someone who ain't like Mr. Beckley and his kindly wife.
I'm really not a fan of an omniscient narrator narrating stuff Holden Caulfield style throughout the whole story. Because, I don't know, it's not subtle. Like, I don't feel like. I'm not feeling the tragedy of the world if you're telling me about the tragedy every 2 feet. You know? I feel a level of disconnect between the narrative, since it's being told to me instead of shown to me or like discovering it, you know? Like what if I talked to one of these dead characters earlier in the game, and then I saw their corpse here now? That would have such more of a profound like effect on how I felt. I would actually have emotion mustered from such a thing. Instead, like, oh, he's telling me this is Mr. Wiffle Waffle and his wife, Miss Bottom Baggins.
Like him.
And they died. Okay. Oh, whoa. There's someone down there. Finally, a character.
Kid sees him there agape in the flesh.
Especially since a game is one of the few, like, mediums where you can experience a story in such a fashion.
It's a snag or two trying to get to him.
Oh, shit. Oh, I have the gun, too. Yeah, I was going to test this out. It's kind of like a machine gun. That's awesome. But yeah, video games are one of the only mediums in which you can do such a type of storytelling.
No matter what.
Such experience-style storytelling. It just goes against the medium to still, like, give me an audiobook. That's what it feels like, a fucking audiobook, man. If I want to listen to a podcast, I'll go listen to a fucking podcast. Yeah.
He's got so many questions, after all.
I'm an opinionated sort of guy. Oh, I could actually shield this shit. Finally, a use for this. But that's part of why I want to play all these games. Part of it is, you know, it gives me a goal in life, beating cool games and seeing what they're about and seeing what other games did. But it also gives me a perspective on all sorts of different styles of games. And I don't know, this style is not one I approve of. And I really question why this game was so well received, with such glaring flaws in its storytelling and gameplay. Oh, hi there, Ed Hell Dude! Yeah, I'm playing through the game, and I'm just giving my thoughts so far. I mean, I love Ron Perlman as an actor. Shit, I should start watching Sons of Anarchy, because he's in that, and I love Ron Perlman. I really think he's just a really good actor. But, I mean, he's also good at voices, too. But, I don't know.
The Tundra Brothers didn't make it.
Oh, so downcast.
They never saw what it was like beyond the walls.
I really feel like it's a poor decision to have the narrator tell me all these things. Like, it's such a disconnect from what's happening. Like, the person experiencing it right now is not even talking about it. It's some guy who's watching me play. So I'm listening to some guy watching
Nordy
me play.
The bird boy didn't make it.
Alright, yes. This level is supposed to introduce me to the tragedy of the world. But I don't feel the tragedy.
The Jawsons, they didn't make it.
Okay, no one did, except that weirdo. That weird kabuki-looking dude down there. Bastion has an 89%? That's strange to me. Godhand gets shit on, and things like Bastion get high ratings. I mean, it's a well-made game, but honestly, I feel like it's devoid of life. Get it? Because the world's been destroyed. Oh, I don't have my soundboard up. What a terrible moment to not have the soundboard engaged. Fuck. I had to disable it when I was using my keyboard.
Grady Senior, Grady Junior, they didn't make it. But him, he survived.
Who did? Oh yeah, wait, where's the guy? There's the guy! Dude, you look so morose, man. Snap out of it. You must be sad like I am that you weren't able to go get the cool items in that level that we completed too early without realizing it. Ooh, an Ura sigil?
Kid finds proof enough that man ain't from around here.
An insignia borne by people of Ura heritage. The Tazzle Spade was a rare sign in Salandia before the Calamity. Now there are fewer. Okay. Interesting. I still want to find my way to this dude. He's the only person who'll talk to me who isn't Ron Perlman.
Without that man, we wouldn't be here right now, would we?
What? No, I'd still kind of be wandering the level, Perlman. Did he cause the calamity? Can I shoot him? No, the game doesn't let you hurt him. Oh, fuck. Maybe. Dude, I have a billion of these. One of these will hit you. Oh yeah, I have the wearer with all werewolf.
The core survived as well.
There we go. No, it's not active. There it is. There we go. Oh, that's a cool effect. That's neat. Dude, you are so powerful at low health. It's also very easy to avoid damage, so I'm gonna hang with low health. I can't access this. Oh,
he
I can.
Gets what he has to do.
Break some rocks. Oh, these are people. They were probably trying to embrace the core and give them light before the darkness took them. Oh well. Too bad. Okay.
What do you say to a man who's seen too much?
You say hello. That's what we say, Perlman.
Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this.
Oh, do I speak?
We have to go. Please.
Oh, I saved somebody! Yay!
He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf.
That's totally
no
not how I envisioned him.
He's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind.
This is their art style's very cute.
And to each other, for the first time.
Yay! Will you talk to me? Ron Perlman, shut the fuck up and let him talk. Oh, you have a name. You're Ruckus? The self-hating black man? No, you're Rux. And you are Zulf. Zulf. Who am I? I don't know still. But this is Teddy, and we're gonna play with Teddy first. Come on, Teddy. Don't be like that, Teddy. Come on. Dance with me. Fucking Teddy. He's angry I don't bring him on adventures. Let's go fix that. Let's bring Teddy on adventures. No, I never leveled up. Let's bring Teddy on adventures. Snooze dart. Causes the target to lose consciousness. I kind of want to bring Teddy, but I'm in the spirit of just trying these abilities out. I've tried everything except Mirror Shield, which is just kind of invincibility. I figured out how that works. Bolt Burst. Kind of want to try Snooze Dart. We'll bring Teddy along on some future adventure. Don't worry, Teddy. If you were such a dick and danced with me, I'd take you with me.
Fought the Ura decades ago, but that was then. Things are different between us now.
Okay. What about you? I swore it looked like he had like white face paint or something. Totally not how I envisioned you, Zulf. Yay, I got an achievement. For just doing the game. I think this is the wrong way to go about achievements, but all games do it.
For Zulf, Ceylandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east. We all lost loved ones in the calamity, he says. I don't know how I'm gonna go on without mine. He was born in the Tazzle terminals. The Ura sent him on a mission of peace to our city, and he's lived here ever since.
Okay. I think it's kind of a missed opportunity to just get more voice actors. I'd really rather they pay, kind of like Elder Scrolls style, just like pay for nobodies to talk. I mean, Ron Perlman has the sexiest, manliest voice, yes, but His voice alone doesn't make this world come alive. Especially since the world's so colorful, and his gruffness and sadness and constant depression, it stands in stark contrast to the fucking, like, art style of this game. I don't feel sad! I mean, this fucking thing twirls with me! Okay, now I'm sad because he's angry. But I don't feel sad in the slight. Even the darkest levels are colorful. I feel like there's a disconnect, like a clash within how the game's presenting itself versus how it actually looks. I don't know, man. I don't know. Maybe this was a proof of concept. I hope Transistor's better, because this is not really winning me over. Alright, we're gonna rock these items. We're gonna rock this stuff. What else are we gonna do? Oh, we could upgrade things! We could upgrade this! Nah! The machete is like, at least the fang repeater has some redeeming quality. The machete's crap.
The cores. They remember. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be alright.
I think Ron Perlman would make a pretty bitchin' cowboy. I mean, he makes a pretty bitchin', motorcyclist.
Well, look what we have here.
Oh, I could build a memorial? Or a lost and found. We should make a memorial. We saw all those dead people. That'd be kind. I don't know what this does, but hey.
The memorial. Yeah, a kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind.
Wait, what? Oh, these are challenges, or is it just kind of telling me? Discover the Lost Mementos. Gain the required number of secret skills. Defeat a foe by counter-blocking its melee attack while at less than 20%. Hit 15 enemies without missing? Defeat 10? Whoa, wow. What, the blunderbuss? I haven't found the blunderbuss. Defeat a big foe with the last bowl. Eh, I don't care to do these. Oh, I can claim them? Oh, I gotta turn in.
Valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more.
Oh, this is Ron Perlman's art. Okay. He's also one hell of an artist. Okie dokie.
Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got.
That's all they hired you to do, Perlman. You're doing a bang-up job! Don't be hard on yourself, man. Don't be hard on yourself, Perlman. That's it, right? That's everything we did here. Okay, let's go to the next area. Oh, did I switch out my super? I totally did. Let's continue.
We tracked down a couple more cores near the edge of the city.
I really wish I could revisit levels.